Why is yawning contagious?
Cause everybody wants to sleep.
Nah. There are a couple of theories which explain why yawning is contagious. One of them suggests that it is a sign of empathy. Empathy is the ability to understand and share others' feelings. For example, when people around us are happy and smiling, they make a positive impact on us. Hence, we also feel good and begin to smile. Moreover, the closer we are to someone such as our parents or friends, the more likely we are to catch their yawn.
Dude, that's awesome!
Another theory suggests that mirror neurons present in our brain make us copy or mimic the actions performed by someone else. Hence, when we see people around us yawn, our mirror neurons get activated, thus making us mimic their yawn. We may have evolved such characteristic to promote social bonding.
Why do dogs lick their wounds?
Dogs, including animals like cats, chimpanzees, rodents, etc., don't have access to a proper medical treatment. Hence, a little licking helps to heal and clean the wound.
What? But how?
When dogs lick, they apply saliva on their wounds. This saliva has antiviral and antibacterial compounds like an enzyme called lysozyme. Lysozyme destroys cell walls of certain bacteria and helps kill them, thus preventing infection. The saliva also contains a protein called tissue factor, which promotes blood clotting and thus stops bleeding. Besides this, licking also removes dirt from the wound.
So dogs should always lick their wounds.
No, excess licking is not beneficial. This is because a dog's saliva can also contain harmful pathogens. They could aggravate the wound and make it more painful. Hence, nowadays, dogs are made to wear an Elizabethan collar to prevent them from licking. What is sleep paralysis?
No idea.
Sleep paralysis is a condition in which we are conscious but temporarily unable to move or speak. It can usually occur when we suddenly wake up during REM sleep.
What is REM sleep?
Basically, there are four stages of sleep. One of them is rapid eye movement sleep. That is, REM sleep. In this stage, we dream. Researchers suggest that when we enter REM sleep, two chemicals, glycine and GABA, switch off the activity of cells in the brain that allow our muscles to move.
Oh no, this is so bad.
No, it is actually beneficial because paralyzed muscles prevent us from enacting our dreams in reality and getting hurt. However, sometimes we suddenly wake up during REM sleep. But if glycine and GABA are still active, we are temporarily unable to move, even though we are conscious. This is called sleep paralysis. What is asthma?
It is a nickname for cinema.
Stop bluffing. Asthma is a lung disease. A person with asthma has red and swollen bronchial tubes with a lot of mucus. As a result, the bronchial tubes get narrower than normal, thus making it hard to breathe. Besides this, the bronchial tubes are highly sensitive to irritants like pollen, tobacco smoke, dust, etc. When an asthmatic person inhales an irritant, the tubes become much more swollen and more mucus is produced. This causes further narrowing of the tubes. This narrowing makes exhalation harder than inhalation. Hence, carbon dioxide-rich air gets trapped in the person's body and he does not get sufficient supply of fresh oxygen. As a result, the person can have severe shortness of breath and a feeling of tightness in the chest. When an asthmatic person experiences such problems, he is said to have an asthma attack. Why does Saturn have rings?
Because it has got engaged.
No. Scientists don't exactly know why Saturn has rings, but they think that it is related to Roche limit.
What is Roche limit?
Roche limit is the distance from the planet at which objects in orbit around the planet tend to be ripped apart by the planet's gravitational pull. Now, based on the Roche limit, one of the prevailing theories is that Saturn's rings are remnants of celestial bodies like a moon or a comet. Billions of years ago, a celestial body may have got too close to Saturn exceeding the Roche limit. Hence, its side facing the Saturn was pulled more strongly as compared to the side facing away. So this inconsistent gravitational pull may have ripped apart the celestial body into pieces. Oh. Finally, these pieces may have started revolving around Saturn, forming its beautiful rings.